Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Emily and I talk a lot about Salesforce. Today we're going to be talking about Salesforce certification days. This is a really awesome, useful tool that Salesforce offers us, and you don't see a lot about it on the internet as far as what it actually is. So I wanted to kind of sit down and explain that to you. So I have taken a few certification days webinars, and I feel like I have a pretty good grasp on what they are, so I feel like I can tell you. I've taken one for the app builder as well as the advanced admin, different certification days. These are free day-long webinars that Salesforce puts on to help people understand about the exam and what's going to be covered on the exam and some of the nitty-gritty that is covered on the exam as well. When you get started, you go to the certification days page on Trailhead website and you register for one in your time zone. Or not necessarily in your time zone, but a time that works for you, because I've done some on the East Coast, done some on the West Coast. I'm in Mountain Time, so it's a little different. They both worked for me. But make sure it is in your language. They do offer these in different languages, so be sure to check those out. You will register using your Trailhead account, and a few days prior, you will get a GoToWebinar link. I've used GoToWebinar for this. I'm not sure if they still do. Maybe they use Zoom, but this is going to be a webinar rather than a Zoom conference, if that makes sense. There are typically, it's going to be 5 hours long, so not quite a whole day. There will be 5 50-minute sections with 10-minute breaks for getting snacks, going to the bathroom, so then you don't have to run back and forth. You will not be on camera, so the only person that is on camera will be the instructor. So the instructor works for Salesforce, and they put on the other week-long certification training courses that are put on by Salesforce that are really expensive. So they know what they're talking about. They educate on these courses a lot, but it is just condensed into a free 5-hour version. One thing is that you may or may not cover everything that is on the exam guide, and you won't get into depth in each section. I remember going to the App Builder one, and we probably covered 80% of the material at a surface high level, but about 20% of the material we just didn't have time to get to. Another thing is that you won't be able to ask any questions to your instructor. So if you had any questions pertaining to the material, then you need to go searching for that on your own. Now this can be really good to just get a basic understanding of what is on the exam and then go answering those questions later on. This is personally my study habit, is to get a lot of questions about the specifics and then answer them before moving on to the next section of the studying. But having this 5-hour long session of a high level helps me to gain a bunch of questions over everything on the exam so that I can start my studying going forward. A big thing is that at the end of the course, you will be given a coupon code for a certain amount off of an exam. This is going to be either $30 off, $70 off, or I've seen $100 off of a regular price 200 exam. And that's kind of the basics of it. Again, they're not gonna cover everything. They won't cover everything in depth. This is kind of a way for Salesforce to market what their more expensive week-long certification training process is like. It does help you gain an understanding of what is going to be on the exam at a high level. Do I think that you could pass only by going to the certification days? Maybe. This really, really depends on a lot of different factors. If you are doing the things that are tested on the exam in your day-to-day job, then I think it would help and you would be more likely to pass. But in general, if this is a new certification that you are going for, you don't have a lot of experience with that specific one, then it's less likely that you're going to pass only by going to the certification days, and you'll need to get some other background education on the things covered on the exam. So specifically for the advanced admin exam, one thing that I need to work on for passing that exam is the forecasting and the products parts of Salesforce. I've used other forecasting and other products tools, so I wasn't super familiar with the native aspects of forecasting and products. This was covered at a very high level in the advanced admin certification days course, but it wasn't in depth enough for me to be able to pass the advanced admin exam. So hopefully that helps you understand the level of information covered in the certification days process. Now these aren't going to be super niche certifications that they will cover on the certification days. These are going to be things like admin, advanced admin, app builder, sales and service cloud consultant, as well as developer one. Salesforce offers these a few times a year, and oftentimes they'll have a lot of these within a week or two of each other. I know they've offered them in December as well as in June, so this might be coming up for you. That is a little bit of a certification days overview. I hope that you found this helpful. Well, be sure to give the video a like, subscribe if you want to join the family here on YouTube. If you want to join the email list, you can do so at salesforceemily.com. Check out my courses down below. And thank you so much for joining me. I'll catch you guys in the next one. Bye.